Hi, this is Önder Altınkurt. I'm Technology Product Manager at ING Turkey. I am responsible for implementing database chains into continuous delivery pipeline for the last 2 years. Databases are part of applications. Databases has to be a part of continuous delivery pipeline to ensure the required test and quality chains has to be completed smoothly. Let's think about traditional database deployment. Developers are taking notes during their developments, and when the deployment day came, they compare their scripts with live database and generate a deployment script. It's an error prone method. We have to think about database versions like our applications. We have to version them and we have to deploy what we have tested on our test environments. It's the better method. Software deployments are not very challenging. You can drop your old DLLs, delete them, and copy new one, and you will complete your migration, software migration. But can we do that for databases? It's not possible. It's not possible to drop, create a database, because databases are consist of very valuable data in your culture and very big volume, like purchase and customer. Solution is incremental changes. When you want to upgrade a target environment from version 1 to 4, you will execute scripts in order for 2, 3, 4 to migrate your database. Development, generally, companies use a shared database environment. This database environment has to be under source control, and all of the chains has to be related with application lifecycle management tasks. When you trigger a build for a task, a DevOps database tool will compare development database and release source database and generate an incremental next version script. We couldn't take the latest version for an existing table and use it in a package, because we couldn't use that create script. We have to compare two create scripts and generate an alter statement. A special DevOps tool will do that. What's inside a package? Inside the package, there are some DDL chains like create, alter, drops, and also there are some DML chains like insert updates for your reference data. Traditional method is generally building, not traditional, recommended method is building application and database chains together with a single build and deploying them together. But if your application is serving more than one application, if your database is serving more than one application, you will trigger two different builds for application and database, but you will release them together. Now, take a look at benefits. It's very easy for developers. A DevOps database tool is generating required scripts for you. You don't have to generate any script manually. And when you request a change for live, you can feel relaxed, because everything is tested on your test environments and they will go to production without any modification. Also, you can stop everything that you don't want. For example, for GDPR or KVKK, you can, if there is a missing metadata repository change, you will stop that version and you won't allow it. Let's take a look at tools. Open source tools like Lycubase and Flyway are good for database migrations, but they don't provide a good build mechanism. Data modeling tools can provide some build, but they are lack at automation. Commercial tools has different features when it's compared to each other, but they don't provide same functionality for every database vendor like Oracle, SQL Server, or Postgre. In ING Turkey, our core banking systems are generally hosted on Oracle, and we choose DB Maestro for our database migration tool, DevOps tool, because it supports end-to-end mechanism from source control, build and release, and rollback. Thank you for your attendance. Feel free to contact and ask me anything you want.